upper room, it started with just like six of us. Then it went to 12, 20. And the whole time, we've just created space for God to minister and move. Yes, there's been teaching. Yes, there's been the traditional facets of church. We've had that, but it's always been unto the presence of God just taking over and wrecking us.
Gosh, I'm so sorry. So that's been very beautiful, but our kids grew up in an atmosphere in our home where we would worship and we would have people in, and just his presence has been such, it's just been such an integral part of our marriage, and then especially, you know, when we had kids, of raising them in his presence and just knowing God's not, it's not some cerebral, you know, he's not a theological concept, but he's real and he's accessible, and learning to not only encounter him in his presence, you know, with people in our home, with worship, but as a family, and even for me and my husband, just I think I would say God himself and his presence is a foundation of our lives, our marriage, our family. I wouldn't know how to parent or do marriage without the Lord.
I think the thing that has kept me close with the Lord is just finally realizing how easy it is to know him and to love him and to be his friend. I think I put so many expectations on myself of what it looked like to be a Christian my whole life, and those expectations were like a burden, and they crushed me every single time. And I think when I finally met Jesus just as my friend, and that was all that he wanted from me, he didn't want anything else but friendship, when I realized that, everything became like so much easier. And so it's no longer like a to-do list of things that I need to do throughout a week to make sure that I'm acting a certain way or like behaving like a Christian should behave. It's just friendship with a man, and that's how easy it is. It's simple.
Just join with his song over us tonight. Heaven's song to earth sings, I love you, I love you.
by confessing the name of Jesus, you got grafted into this plan, and it's a plan of redemption that's still playing out today. And so the Maranatha cry, as much as it is about what's to come, it's also understanding what has been. We're stuck in this tension of the kingdom is here and the kingdom is coming. There's this hope of glory that's within us, but this hope of glory that's coming. And we need to emphasize both, but one leads to the other and the other leads to one. Like, there's this beautiful tension and dance between these two realities. And you have people that are like, it's all about the now. And I'm like, yes, it's about the now, but it's also about the until. It's all about the until. Yes, it is about the until, but it's also about the now. There's this urgency in the here and the now that the Maranatha cry brings. It's not an escapist like, oh God, bail us out. It's there's a coming kingdom that's within me. There's a coming kingdom that's around me. There's a coming kingdom that you're invited into.
For the Lord, it's so convicting, and so it's the honor of my ministry so far is my relationship with Marcos and what God's about to do in South America. I just am happy to have a front row seat.
I just, I'm deciding where I'm going to go. It's better than I could have ever dreamed of. It's better than I could have ever planned. It's making music with my family, with my best friends. And all of a sudden, like, we started off in this building at Oaklawn, you know, and then just worshiping together because we love the Lord. And then coming to this building, you know, and the fact that I get to be a part of it, whether it's singing, whether it's setting up, whatever, it's just, I'm just so honored because it's such an answer to my prayers, but it's so much different than I thought, but it's better.
expectant for what God's going to do. For those of you who showed up and you're realizing this is not the normal 6 to 8 set, and we have Carrie and Cody Carnes with us. So a couple months back, Carrie and I were just talking. She had reached out and was talking to me about something that's been stirring in her heart for several months, and about wanting to gather. And can you share a little bit?
Yeah, sure. Hi, everyone. Oh, I just am so expectant tonight, and just really thankful that you've come. And yeah, I just was talking to Elissa about these pop-up Just Jesus nights. I just started burning almost a year ago, honestly, to do these nights where we just go after Jesus and there's just no agenda. We just get together with our good close friends and just go after Jesus. And you know, the beauty of what we get to do is lead people in worship a lot, and we love to do that, we love to steward that, but sometimes we just want to be with our good friends and just get on our faces and just forget the agendas. And so that's what tonight is, and you've come because I think you were stirred probably for the same thing. And we trust our friends. We trust Elissa and Abby and you guys. And I was telling them earlier, we have Upper Room on in our home all the time, and the glory of God will just sweep through. And sometimes I can't even continue doing stuff at the house because I just feel so overtaken by the glory of God. And so it's just an honor for us to be with you tonight and just to go after the Lord and let him do what he wants to do. And if you've come tonight and you're not usually in this kind of environment, I'm so glad you're here, because we're just going to let the Lord do what he does. And we're going to give space for the sacred. We're going to give space for his glory to fall. Abby was talking about it earlier, how a lot of times we'll pray for his glory to come and we'll sing it, but then we move on quickly. And we're just not going to be quick tonight. Hi, Christina. We're just not going to be quick tonight. We're just going to be obedient and give space. And so that's what these nights are for. And this is probably more of a gift from my heart and Cody's heart than anything else, just to be with you and just love on Jesus together. So come on, let's lift our hands and let's just grow straight in. Father, I thank you for your presence and just for the sacred, beautiful, pure presence that you bring. And we're here tonight because we're hungry for more. We're here tonight because we know we've tasted and seen, and we're not full yet. We know there's more. We know there's more. We long to know you in a deeper way. We long to feel your presence and hear your voice and get direction and see visions and prophesy. And whatever you want to do tonight, God, come and do it. Come and move. Come and be mighty. We love you. This night is for you and you alone. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. If you want to come to the front, you can. Just know that there's an option if you want. Yeah, but just begin to sing in the Spirit.
mighty rains. Oh my.
atmosphere of worship. I just, as I was praying for tonight, I just felt the Holy Spirit say, I want you to appropriate my blood. I want you to appropriate my blood. And I started to just, I've heard that phrase, but I just looked up what appropriate means, which also sounds like appropriate. But to appropriate something means to take and use it for a special purpose and to devote it to a special purpose. And as Elissa and I were praying about this night, praying about this, the dynamics of everything and how to do it and when to do it and everything, I had a dream. And in the dream, we were standing backstage and the night was over and there were empty communion cups everywhere. And so I texted her when I woke up. I was like, I think we're supposed to take communion at this Just Jesus. And so tonight, as we do that, first of all, just logistically, the communion cups are located in these little wooden boxes around the room. There's some on stage, and there's some over on the side. And if you just want to get those boxes and maybe just start to pass them out, because I kind of want you to have it in your hand when we enter into this moment together. I'll just give a moment for you to do that, actually. Most of you might have it. I just really feel like this is going to be a really sacred moment between us and Jesus tonight. You know, he says to do this in remembrance of him. And I love that he left a tangible thing for us to drink and to take and to hold and to feel. And he created us this way with all of our senses. And I just love that he just knew that this would be something so sacred and so special for us as believers. To sit and do this in remembrance of him. And when he said to appropriate his blood tonight, I feel like it's an invitation from him to not just do this in remembrance tonight, but to, as you are going to take it, to declare over yourself what you are appropriating and what you're saying that it's for tonight. I think some of you have come tonight and you've been needing breakthrough. Appropriate it to that breakthrough. To say, I appropriate your blood for breakthrough tonight, Jesus. I know a sweet friend came tonight and she needs healing in her kidneys. Miss Lisa, I want you to appropriate the blood of Jesus over your kidneys tonight as you take this communion. Whatever it is you need tonight, I just feel you're supposed to declare what you're taking this and declaring over your life tonight as you take communion. Just in Luke 22 and 19 through 20, it's where it says, and he took the bread and he gave thanks and he broke it and he gave it to them. We don't have to take it yet. I just wanted to read this, but I want you to take this in this next few songs just as you feel ready and led to, just having a moment. But I wanted to read this though before that. And he took bread, gave thanks and broke it and gave it to them saying, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And in the same way, after the supper, he took the cup, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you. Jesus, tonight, we just thank you for a beautiful, sacred thing that you left us so that we could sit and remember all that you've done for us. We thank you for your presence. We thank you that you tore the veil to make access to your presence. In this moment, we thank you for what you did on the cross. The lashes on your back for our healing. The crown of thorns on your head. The pierced side. Your hands and your feet. No one else has ever done anything like that for us, and no one ever will. You gave of your life for our freedom and for our grace and for our healing. Lord, I pray that every person tonight in this room that needs a breakthrough would begin to see it happen tonight. That every healing that is needed in this room, that it would begin tonight. Just appropriate your blood tonight for every situation, and we turn our eyes to Jesus. Just thank you for your blood, Jesus.
Thank you. See you. Give me Jesus. You came tonight. Come on, let's give him some praise. Come on, let's give him some praise. I need to just obey one thing that I'm feeling in my spirit. And I know that there were some pastors that were invited tonight. My parents invited some really close friends of theirs. If you are a pastor of a church in this room, will you lift your hand? I'm putting you on the spot. Yeah. I think this was a Holy Ghost setup for you tonight. I just feel so compelled in my spirit to just put our hands toward them and to pray for fresh wind of the Spirit on your churches and in your houses. Yes. Just a fresh infilling of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
The first love. Just that the Lord would remind you why you fell in love with doing ministry.
Yes.
That the love of the people and that the love of pouring your life out before people would return to you. That the joy of your salvation would return to you. That the covering of the Holy Spirit would be fresh and new for you and your children and your children's children.
Yes.
I just pray against all attack to make you quit or give up or get tired or weary. We pray for fresh wind of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Fresh wind on your marriages, on your children. Fresh wind at your churches, on the worship. Everything that concerns you with the ministry, that the Lord would make it clear. Strength to your bones. Strength to your bones. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for these mighty men and women of God. Fill them afresh tonight. In Jesus' name.
Spoken over the Dallas area, Lord, for revival coming to this nation, Lord, to this state, to this city, to this area. And we just thank you for breathing on every church represented here tonight. We thank you for unifying us as a bride in Dallas, Jesus. We thank you. I thank you that those who water, the Bible says, will be watered. So we thank you for watering these pastors, watering their staff, watering their volunteers, Lord. I thank you for financial blessings coming to these churches. I thank you, Lord, for life and life abundantly in every church represented in this city in Jesus' name. We thank you for an outpouring of your spirit in our city, Jesus. Just lift your hands and pray over these pastors a little longer. We thank you for a fresh outpouring. We agree, Lord. We agree. We agree with every word spoken over every church of why they exist and why they were planted. You heard him and he's faithful. You heard him and he's faithful. So we thank you, Jesus, for fresh fire. I just agree with Carrie. Fresh love. First love. In Jesus' name.
And Lord, I just thank you for this house and my friends. Thank you for how they steward your presence. Lord, thank you for a place cultivating young hearts to go after Jesus with everything. Lord, seal tonight what you've done in our hearts. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your goodness and for an open heaven tonight. Seal this in us. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. Come on, one more shout of praise tonight. So good. Hallelujah. Amen.
Guys, can we thank Carrie and Cody for coming tonight? Guys, thank you so much for coming. Meet someone next to you. Go eat. Go have fun. Be safe in the rain. We do have to lock this building up.